Hello, my dear students. My name is Hanmant Ladwa. Welcome to Vision Academy. In this video, we are going to study real numbers, class 10 maths. So here, let us have the introduction of real numbers. Here, question comes, what are the real numbers? So real numbers are all the numbers that includes natural number, whole number, integers, rational and irrational number. So picturally we can represent, so n is natural number. So natural number always starts from 1, so that is example as 1, 2, 3 and so on. And next, here we can have whole numbers. So whole numbers always starts from 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. Next, we'll be having integers. So integer consisting of both negative, positive, including 0. So that is -1, -2, 0, even +1, 2 and so on. Next, we'll move on to rational numbers. So rational numbers are in the form of p by q. So any number you can take, any integer or whole numbers, so all numbers comes under rational numbers only. After rational number, we'll get irrational numbers. So irrational numbers such as, for example, square root of 2, square root of 3 or square root of 5 are the irrational numbers. Now, on top of irrational number, all together we'll be having real numbers. Now let us study the important properties of positive integers. So here we'll write properties of positive integers. So here the first property of the positive integer is Euclid's division algorithm. The next important properties of the positive integer is fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Here Euclid's division algorithm gives us, here the number which is divided by another number called b, which leaves the remainder r. So here q is the quotient where 0 is less than or equal to remainder is less than the divisor. So here a is dividend, b is divisor, q is quotient and r is remainder. So here Euclid's division algorithm is used to compute highest common factor of a given numbers. So let us take example. Here we'll take example such as 17, 6. So here 17 is acting as a dividend and 6 is acting as a divisor. So let us divide 17 by 6. So here 6 2s are 12 and here we'll remain with 5. So here 5 is remainder, which cannot be divided further by 6. So here we are going to write using this Euclid's division algorithm. Here dividend is 17 is equal to divisor is 6, that is b, into quotient is 2, that is 6 2s are 12, plus remainder is 5. So 6 2s are 12, 12 plus 5 is again 17. So similarly, here we'll take one more example of this kind. So here we'll write 5, 12. Let us take 5 as dividend and 12 as divisor. In this case we'll write 5 is equal to, so let us divide 5 by 12. So here 5 cannot be divided by 12 because 5 is less than 12. So that's the reason here quotient will take 0. So 12 zeros are 0. So 5 minus 0. So this gives us 5. So remainder is 5. So same can be written as 5 is equal to 12, that is divisor into quotient is 0 plus remainder is 5. So anything into 0, that is 12 into 0 is 0. 0 plus 5 is, again we are going to get 5. So let us take one more example of this kind, 20 comma 4. So here 20 is acting as dividend and 4 is acting as a divisor. So let us divide this 20 by 4. So here 4 5s are 20. So remainder will become 0. So similarly, applying Euclid's division algorithm, here dividend is 20 is equal to b is divisor, so that is 4, into quotient is 5 plus remainder is 0. So this gives us 4 5s are 20 plus remainder is 0. Now let us move on to another properties of the positive integers, that is fundamental theorem of arithmetic. So here fundamental theorem of arithmetic has got the multiplication of numbers such as composite numbers. As we already know that composite numbers are nothing but they are the product of primes or prime numbers. So here fundamental theorem of arithmetic has got two more applications. So here the first application of fundamental theorem is finding out the irrationality of the number. Irrationality of the number such as square root of 2, square root of 3 and square root of 5. So similarly, one more application of fundamental theorem of arithmetic is decimal expansion of rational numbers. So rational numbers are always in the form of p divided by q form, where q is not equal to 0. So what will happen, suppose if q is equal to 0. So if q is equal to 0, then obviously the result will become infinite. So let us move on to Euclid's division lemma. So Euclid's division lemma is nothing but Euclid's division algorithm only. So here we are going to write the theorem of Euclid's division lemma. So here they have given the positive integers a and b. There exist unique integers like q and r satisfying a is equal to b into q plus r, where 0 is less than or equal to remainder is less than divisor. So here a is dividend, b is divisor, into quotient plus remainder. So here 0 is always less than or equal to remainder and remainder is always less than the divisor. Now let us take example. So here we'll take example 455 and 42. Now here there is a condition where we can say a is equal to bq plus r. So q may be 0 or even r may be 0, because we have already seen here q is 0 and here you can see the remainder r is 0. So next, one more condition before we divide or before we use Euclid's division lemma to these two numbers to find HCF of the number, because here we have already written one of the important applications of Euclid's division algorithm is used to compute highest common factor. So highest common factor gives us the number which divides both the numbers. Now here we'll see the important condition is 455 is greater than 42. So always larger number should get divided by the smaller number. Now let us write 455 is greater than 42. Now we'll use the long division method of dividing 455 by 42. Here we can write 42 tens are 420. So let us subtract 420 from 455. So here we are going to get 35 as remainder. So let us take this remainder further as divisor, and dividend is 42. So 35 ones are 35. Here we remain with 42 minus 35 gives us 7 as remainder. Now let us further divide this 35 by 7. So 7 fives are 35 and here remainder is 0. Here we are going to stop dividing. Here we got 7 as divisor, and this is the HCF of both of these two number that divides both of these two number by 7. So same can be written using Euclid's division lemma. So that is dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So here in the first step, the dividend is 455 is equal to 42 is the divisor into quotient is 10 plus remainder is 35. Now further in the second step, you can see the dividend is 42 and the divisor is 35 into quotient is 1 plus remainder is 7. Now move on to step 3. Here you can see 35 is dividend and 7 is divisor and quotient is 5 plus remainder is 0. So here this 7 divisor is acting as a highest common factor which divides both of these two numbers, that is 455 and 42. So now we can come to the conclusion that here therefore HCF of 455, 42 is equal to 7. Let us solve example number 1. Use Euclid's algorithm to find the HCF of 4052 and 12576. Now let us find the solution for the given problem. Here we need to find highest common factor of these two positive integers. Here you can clearly see that 12576 is greater than 4052. Hence, we are going to use Euclid's division algorithm to find the HCF of these two numbers. So let us divide this given number, that is 12576 by 4052. So here we'll take 4052, how much are 12576? So here almost around 3 if I take. So 4052 3s are. Now multiply this 4052 into 3. So 3 2s are 6, 3 5s are 15, carry 1 5, 3 0s are 0, carry 1 as it is, 3 4s are 12. So which is nearly equal to 12576. So let us write here 12156. So subtract it, 6 minus 6 is 0. 7 minus 5 is 2, 5 minus 1 is 4, 2 minus 2 is 0 and 1 minus 1 is 0. So here we are going to get 420. So this 420 is acting as a divisor and this 4052 as acting as dividend. Now let us divide 4052 by 420. So here 420 tens are, it will become 4200, which is greater than that of 4052. So let us take 420 nines are. So 9 zeros are 0, 9 twos are 18, 9 fours are 36 plus 1 37, which is nearly equal to this particular number. So let us take 420 nines are 3780. So let us subtract, 2 minus 0 is 2. Let us take carry, 15 minus 8 is 7. So let us take carry. So 10 minus 8 gives us 2. 4 minus 4 is 0. So it will become 272. Now this 272 is acting as divisor, and here the dividend is 420. So 420 will be divided by 275. So 272. So here 272, how much is 420? If I take 272 2s, it will become 500 and something. So we'll take 1s. So it will become 272. Let us subtract. So take carry. 10 minus 2 is 8. Let us take carry. 12 minus 8 is 4. 4 minus 3 is 1. So 140 is acting as divisor and 272 is acting as dividend. So now 148, how much is 271? So here 148 ones are. So it will become 148. Now let us subtract, take carry. So 12 minus 8 is 4. So 7 minus 5 gives us 2. 2 minus 1 is 1. So 124 is acting as divisor and 148 is dividend. Now let us further divide 124. Sorry, it is 124 ones are 124. Here you can see 8 minus 4 is 4, 4 minus 2 is 2, and 1 minus 1 is 0. So 24 is acting as divisor, and here you can write 124 as dividend. So 24, how much is 124? So 24, 5 is 120. So here 4 is remain. Next, this 24 will take as dividend. So here 4 is divisor and 24 is dividend. Now 4 6 are 24. So here we'll get remainder 0. Here this 4 is acting as HCF of the given numbers. So let us write the same using Euclid's division lemma. So in the first step, you can see here the dividend is 12,576 is equal to divisor is 4052 into quotient is 3 plus remainder was 420. Now in the second step, you can see here this 4052 is acting as dividend and the divisor is 420. Here you can see 420 into quotient is 9 plus remainder is 272. In the next step, 420 is acting as a dividend and here divisor is 272 into quotient is 1 plus remainder is 148. Now 272 is acting as dividend and 148 is divisor. 148 into 1 plus remainder is 124. Next, 148 is acting as dividend and you can see here divisor is 124 into 1 plus remainder is 24. 124 is acting as the dividend. Next, divisor is 24 into quotient is 5 plus remainder is 4. Here we'll write 24 as dividend in the next step. Next, divisor is 4 into 6 is the quotient plus remainder is 0. So here 6 4s are 24. So here this last divisor is called as the HCF of the given number. So here we can write, therefore, HCF of 4052 comma 12,576 is equal to 4. Now let us solve example number 2. Show that every positive even integer is of the form 2q and that every positive odd integer is of the form 2q plus 1 where q is some integer. So they have asked us to find every positive integer is of the form 2q and every positive odd integer is of the form 2q plus 1. So as per Euclid's division algorithm, Here we can write A is equal to B into Q plus R. So where A is the dividend, B is the divisor, Q is the quotient and R is the remainder. And the condition for this one is where 0 is less than or equal to R, which is always less than B, that is divisor. Now let us write, as per the question, we have to show that every positive even integer, here they have given it is in the form of 2q. So 2q and every positive odd integer is of the form 2q plus 1. So as per Euclid's division algorithm, once we substitute the value of this 2 in place of b, so here b will become 2. So here we'll write b is equal to 2 and a is any positive integer. Now let us substitute. So a is equal to, in place of b we are going to write 2q plus, here r value is equal to, either it may be 0 or r is equal to 1. Why? Because here we have got b is equal to 2, which is always less than b. So that is r is always less than b means what? R is either 0 or 1. It cannot be 2 because b is equal to 2. Less than 2 means 1. Now here we'll write a is equal to 2q plus, for the first time we are going to substitute the value of r as 0. So that is 2q plus 0. So this gives us 2q, which is positive because the remainder is 0. So here, which is having no remainder, is called as positive even number. Now let us substitute a is equal to 2q plus, in place of r we are going to substitute 1. So that is 2q plus 1. So this gives us what? 2q plus 1. Here in place of r, that is remainder 1 we got. Hence it is positive odd integer. Now let us solve example number 3. Show that any positive odd integer is of the form 4q plus 1 or 4q plus 3, where q is some integer. Here let us find the solution for the given problem. Here we need to show that the positive odd integer is of the form 4q plus 1 or 4q plus 3, where q is some integer. So whether it is odd or not, how do we determine? It is dependent on the remainder. Using Euclid's division lemma, we can write, here a is any positive integer which divides by the divisor b into q plus r, where 0 is less than or equal to, remainder is always less than the divisor. So here let us substitute in place of b. Here we can write b is equal to 4, because here in the question they have given 4q plus 1. 4 is the divisor, q is quotient, plus 1 is remainder. Similarly, here 4 is the divisor, q is quotient, and 3 is remainder. So here b is equal to 4. So here r value could be 0, 1, 2, or it is 3, because b is equal to 4. So here we can write 0 is less than or equal to, r value could be 0, 1, 2, or 3. Here we can write r is less than b is 4. So r value could be either 0, 1, 2, or 3. So let us substitute the same in the Euclid's division lemma. So here a is equal to b is 4 into q plus, r is, for the first time we'll write 0. Here we'll write if r is equal to 0, then we'll get a is equal to 4q plus 0. So this gives us 4q. Next we'll substitute, if r is equal to 1, then we can write a is equal to 4q plus 1. If r is equal to 2, then we can write a is equal to 4q plus 2. If r is equal to 3, then we can write a is equal to 4q plus 3. You can see both of these two, that is 4q and 4q plus 2. This gives us even numbers. So even positive numbers are 4q and 4q plus 2, because 2 is even number. Next we'll write here odd positive numbers are, you can see here 4q plus 1 and 4q plus 3. 4q plus 1 and 4q plus 3 are the odd numbers. Now let us move on to example number 4. A sweet seller has 420 kaju burfis and 130 badam burfis. She wants to stack them in such a way that each stack has the same number and they take up the least area of the tray. What is the number of that can be placed in each stack for this purpose? So here we need to find a HCF of the given number of kaju burfis and number of badam burfis. So here she wants to stack them in such a way that each stack has the same number. So stacking is nothing but keeping kaju burfi as well as badam burfi one on the top of the other. Now let us find the solution for the given problem. Here we need to find HCF of 420 and 130. So here clearly you can see 420 is greater than 130. Hence we are going to use Euclid's division lemma. So let us divide 420 by 130. So here 130 threes are will take 130 into 3. So 3 zeros are 0, 3 threes are 9, 3 ones are 3. So it is nearly equal to 420. So here we'll write 390 and subtract it from 420. So 0 minus 0 is 0. So 12 minus 9 gives us 3, 4 minus 4 is 0. So we got 30. So this 30 is acting as divisor and this 130 is acting as dividend. So let us divide 130 by 30. So here 30, how much is 130? So that is 34 is 120. Here we are going to get remainder 0, that is 10. So let us write 10 as divisor and 30 as dividend. So 10, how much is 30? 10, 3 is 30. So here remainder will become 0. So this 10 is acting as HCF of 420 and 130. So same can be written using Euclid's division algorithm in a step-by-step manner. So here we'll write in the first step, 420 as dividend is equal to divisor is 130 into quotient is 3 plus remainder is 30. In the second step, here we'll write 130 is the dividend and 30 is the divisor, quotient is 4 plus remainder is 10. Next, 30 is acting as dividend and here 10 is divisor and 3 is quotient and 0 is the remainder. So here this 10 is acting as HCF. So therefore we can come to the conclusion that the sweet seller can make a stack of 10 both kinds of burfis.
Hello my dear students, thank you very much for watching this video. My name is Hanumant Ladva. If you want to watch the next video, you can click on this icon, and if you want to get the latest updated videos, then you can click on this button to subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Jai Hind, Vande Mataram.